Well, hello, Front Street. Delighted to have you with us today. This is a little bit different video than you're normally seeing. We're talking about a new series of messages, but also a whole different way of viewing something that we may have viewed in a way that might not have been helpful. And we're calling it Pathways to Generosity. Now, back in the fall, our finance team and visioning team decided that we really need to change the way we think about stewardship. And we asked a consulting group called Horizon Stewardship to help us. And historically, churches, including ours, we've talked about stewardship, and you know, I know what you think right now, oh, this is about money. Pathways of Generosity is an emphasis that we're going to try to hone in on these next few weeks, which is about generosity from head to toe, of your time, of, yeah, your money, of when do you go that extra mile? How do you do that? How do we develop a life of generosity? Because really, we believe biblically, that's really what stewardship and all our entire life can be wrapped up. Disciples' life is they are a generous people. And so we're going to try to spend a few weeks talking about how do we go about developing a life of generosity. You're going to receive brochures and letters and this sort of thing to tell you what our financial needs are and all that. But so many of our people, so many of us, and I get it, we saw what we did with the courtyard and saw all that beautiful place that we've created, an outdoor living space. And now we're looking at the columbarium, and that's an expensive endeavor, about $170,000. And we look at it, and I know what you're thinking, well, we must have plenty of money. Well, here's the deal with that. This area, by the way, is where the columbarium is going to go. That's actually where one of the columbariums will be, right here. Columbarium DNC, right here. And the sidewalk's going to be moved. You'll see all that soon. But this columbarium and the courtyard, those are different buckets. Those do not come out of general fund giving. Those do not come out of youth ministry or music ministry. Those things are being given by people like you who give regularly to the ministries and to the general fund of Front Street. But they give additionally on top of that, as these are gifts. These are people that have learned the gift of generosity, and they said, hey, we want to help with this. And it's not only this columbarium, we're going to re-landscape the whole front of the church from one corner to the other, a brand new landscape, a beautiful new additional living room, gathering space for us, the people that got at Front Street. Those come out of what we often call endowment or and people just being generous and wanting to help us and to make our environment more welcoming, more loving, to make a difference as a gift to you. Each person, every one of us, through this Pathways of Generosity, Pathways to Generosity, each person is going to be invited to consider where you are on your giving path. It's not about the church's need to fund a budget. It's really about you and me responding out of God's blessing in our own lives, and how might God be leading us to grow in our own personal generosity. Have you ever known a really generous person? Now, the second question, have you ever known an unhappy, generous person? My guess is never, because it builds into something in our character and who we are. So, We're going to share with you your giving path, and it's like levels of giving. We're not going to try to tell you this is what you should do. What we're going to do is hear our levels of giving and begin moving. Like you might be a first-time giver. Maybe you've never given anything to church before. Might you over a year give $100? That's huge. And then there's an intentional giver, which they are giving a percentage of their income. And then there's a growing giver, which is a person who has decided they're going to increase their giving every year. There is a tither, those of us who've made it to giving 10% back of everything we receive. And then there are these people that are extravagant givers. I would say the folks that have provided the funds for these things that are going on here are probably in that category. They're looking for ways that they can bless people. And then later, you're going to receive regularly in your email, every day, you're going to receive a devotion, which is going to help guide you. We're recording people who will read it, and you can just listen to it and focus on that devotion. And then on September 29th, we're going to have our Pathways to Generosity Sunday, where we will bring our estimate of giving cards or fill them out right there. And we're literally going to take time out in the service to pray, Lord, not my will, but yours be done. Lord, what are you leading me to do at Front Street United Methodist Church today? Well, that's a long way of saying thank you, number one, because you are a generous church. Because I've discovered, like many of you, nothing will give you a greater blessing than when you are giving yourself. I have a friend who runs a ministry, and he received from some friends a gift of $500, which made a difference, a huge difference in their ministry. No, just note here, use it for this. It was just a gift. Here, I want y'all to use this. Well, you know what happened next year? They felt so changed by that gift in their life that they felt God moving on them to give another family a gift. And so that next year, that following Christmas, they had a close friend, his family. They were not going to have a Christmas. They didn't know this, but they were not going to have Christmas. But God moved on them and said, hey, you remember that $500? What if you pay that forward? And they gave that family $1,500. Lo and behold, if they hadn't given that $1,500, that family would not have had Christmas. That may be where God leads you. Now, most pastors would die about this. God may be leading you. You know what? You've got to give for Front Street, but I've got a project for you. I would tell you, go take care of that project too. That's where God wants you to be. And so that's my prayer for you. Not that we're going to fundraise you or nitpick you, no, or manipulate you. No, that I'm not interested in. But we are interested in see where is God leading you. So I'm going to invite you to come along with this Pathways to Generosity. I'm going to be right along there with you. And we're going to be a different people afterwards. I can't wait to get past September 29th to see what has God done through the people we call Front Street. Hey, thanks a lot. Appreciate you being here tonight. If you're watching with an affinity group or today, thank you for watching at home. We're humbled that you're here and you're a blessing to us. We'll see you next time.